If I asked you, if we just kind of even got in a group and I took a poll and said, okay, everybody just comment below right here. Or everybody, if you're watching this with a group of people, like raise your hand. Or just you, go to the coffee shop and ask people, hey, how many of Jesus's miracles weren't miracles? Well, if I said that, you would think I was crazy. You'd say, no. Like everything that he did was a miracle. Every time he healed somebody, it was a miracle. But let me show you something really interesting that you see in the Bible. Okay, and by the way, I actually believe they're all miracles too. So let me give you that disclaimer. Let me show you something that's incredible that you see in the Bible. Now, this isn't an isolated phenomenon. In fact, the next point that I want to show you is both types of healing. Number five is both types of healing actually happen in harmony with one another throughout Jesus's ministry. So in Matthew chapter 8, there's this incredible sequence of miracle stories. What happens is Jesus is just kind of broken onto the scene, and then he goes to Simon Peter's mother-in-law's house, and the Bible says that she's sick there with a fever. Now, this wouldn't just be like an elevated temperature. This is literally probably something where she's on her deathbed. And the Bible says this. It says, okay, Jesus had come into Peter's house. He saw his wife's mother lying sick with a fever. So he touched her hand and the fever left her. Then she arose and she served them. She began cooking dinner for all the house guests. That, in my mind, is an iomei. That's an instantaneous healing. Even though we don't see the word used right there, it's clearly Jesus touched her and instantly she's better. This is just like my brother's eye. This is just like my sister's heart. This is just like Ivy laying hands on and praying for those two different women. This is just like the blind man that Jesus healed, the lame man that Jesus healed, the paralytic that was dropped through the roof to his feet while he's teaching, when, by the way, this guy didn't have faith. It was the faith of the friends, therefore showing you even more that you can't fit the faith thing in a box. This with Simon Peter's mother-in-law, instantaneous iomei. But let me show you the rest of the story. When evening had come, the townspeople, they brought to him many who were demon-possessed, and he cast out the spirits with the word, and he healed, now catch this, he healed all who were sick. He healed all who were sick. Now here's something that troubled me is, like the Bible says that Jesus healed them all, and then Jesus himself says in John 14, he says, you're going to do greater works than I'm going to do. In Mark 16, he says, you're going to lay hands on sick people and they're going to recover. Yet the tension is, we don't heal them all like he did. Well, maybe here's one of the reasons that might not happen. It says he healed all. He therapeuted all of them. It's like what happens is this, is he instantaneously hears Simon Peter's mother-in-law, and then the whole crowd's there, some of them get instantly healed, all of them, he teaches how to walk in health and wellness. He teaches them how to be well. Now, this isn't an isolated phenomenon in Scripture. In fact, point number six is this. We see both types of healing in the Apostle Paul's ministry too. Okay, here's the story. In Acts chapter 28, there is this ship that many people, about 276 people who are traveling with Paul are on. And the ship's going to crash. It's been in a storm for days. And then it does crash and it's wrecked against an island. Well, Paul's there and he's been a prisoner in chains, and this viper comes out of the woods and it grabs Paul on the hand, and Paul instantly flips it off and flings it in the fire and he doesn't die. So people think, wow, something must be happening here. Well, that gets Paul an invitation to the former chief's house where he lays sick with a fever. And by former chief, I mean like the chief's son who's acting as chief, Publius. He invites him to go see his father, who also has the same kind of deathly ill fever that Peter's mother-in-law had. The Bible says this. It says that Paul reaches down, lays hand, and heals the chief, and immediately he's better. The word there is iomei. Paul instantaneously heals the chief. Well, Scripture goes on and it says this. It says, then the entire island, all of the villagers, all of the islands gathered there together to the chief's house. And it says this, that Paul healed them all. The word there is Paul therapeuted them all. You see what happens there in the ministry of Jesus and in the ministry of Paul? Is instantaneous healing happens. 30 times throughout the New Testament, the word is used. Also, these both teach other people how to be well. therapeuo happens, the word is used, 40 times in the New Testament. He's a